Dan salam sejahtera. Okay, video kali ini saya akan guide tentang I'll be guiding you on what is how to put images or image inside your HTML document. Okay, so HTML so images can improve the design and the appearance of web pages. Alright, so any elegant looks and how do you present the website. Okay, kalau you nak tengok buatkan website tu more corporate look, okay, so sesuai dengan tema website tersebut. Alright, corporate website, personal website, e-commerce website, it's all about using graphics. Alright, graphics and images. So how do you perform a good graphics and a good images depends on your creativity and your technical skill. Tapi dimestikan every website yang kita kata nak menarik perhatian, technicality-nya image yang diguna pakai mestilah dalam bentuk yang orang kata high quality tapi maintain capability untuk increase speed of website tu. Dia tak mengganggu speed loading website tersebut lah. Okay, so now we're going to look into how to perform to insert image in HTML document using image IMG syntax or IMG element. So firstly, in this tutorial I'm going to create a new folder. Okay, so create new folder inside here. Alright, name it as image HTML tutorial. Alright, so dalam ni, so dalam ni yang kita akan dapat ada content apa tu. So dalam content, dalam folder ni adalah content images and our index file, index HTML file kat sini lah. So I'm going to use our my text editor, save it first as index HTML. So now, okay, inside this folder, okay, find working project ni. Alright, name it as index.html because every first home page yang kita nak guna dalam kita punya project mestilah kita rename sebagai index. Alright, save it, and now we have index.html in our working project, and pull out HTML skeleton, HTML document ni. And for the title, kita bagi je title apa saja yang kita nak pakai related to content yang kita nak letak dalam page ni lah. Alright, for this one I'm going to use HTML image tutorial. Alright, so image to HTML to image tutorial. So I'm going to give a title, HTML image tutorial. Alright, done. So back to our working folder, we have index files here, execute, and we have this simple document yang kita dah create lah. So dalam folder yang sepatutnya. Alright, so index HTML, this one heading yang kita baru buat lah. Alright, so now how to create a image. Alright, so image yang kita nak guna pakai mesti kita compile dan letak dalam satu folder. So create a new folder, name it as images. Alright, so image, so dalam root folder mesti ada, kena ada folder file HTML and folder image. So dalam folder image ni, di sini ada kita punya image yang nak pakai lah. Okay, sebelum kita guna, kita cari dulu gambar. Alright, so dalam ni kita dah ada few gambar yang kita dah pakai. Okay, saya just copy je yang ini, copy back to working project. So here, paste je kat sini. Okay, so we have images inside image folder. Okay, image folder ni ada dekat root folder sekali dengan index file. Okay, now for syntax untuk image, kita gunakan IMG. So IMG adalah element, HTML element atau syntax that pull out image. Okay, image and declare source dia daripada mana. Alright, declare source dia daripada mana. So source daripada mana? Adalah source kepada image tersebut. Source of the image. Where is the image located? So now, inside our working project, the selected image that we're going to use, for example, this laptop.jpg, okay, resides in our images folder. Okay, so disebabkan index ni dekat dalam root folder, kita terus je bagi alamat dia images/laptop.jpg. Alright, so the location for this folder, the location of the images. Okay, so first name of the folder. Alright, and the name of the file. Okay, laptop.jpg. Okay, so we must include file types ni. Okay, so file type kita ada beberapa lah. Okay, so we have the most popular one, JPG, PNG, BMP, GIF. So this one is animated. Okay, animated, animated graphics lah. And then we have TIFF and we have SVG. Okay, scalar vector graphics ni. Alright, scalar vector graphics ni special because you know the based on mathematical punya mathematical punya calculation. So bila image tu you besarkan juga, dia takkan pecah. Okay, SVG. Okay, they based on XML actually. They based on XML punya language, SVG ni. Now back to our graphics. Okay, close, save. Okay, save, and of course inside our the same page ni, we refresh. So we have a laptop here. Okay, this is a very simple execution, simple syntax to pull out image into our HTML document. Alright, so image laptop.jpg. So we have another syntax that we're going to scale down the image if you need to. Alright, just add height or width. Okay, height or width. This one height tinggi dan juga lebar. Okay, so we begin with height first. Height equal to, so any measurement is measurement for height or width, we measure it in pixel or px. Alright, so height. Maybe we're going to declare 300px pixels and save. And the browser will render the image with the height 300 pixel. Save. Oh, is it 300 pixel? Height. Save. Oh, save. Okay, this is the first picture and this is the second picture. So we have two pictures here, one and two. This one without the height declaration and this one with height declaration. And you can also include a width, okay, along with height, but the image will follow the height and width, so gambar tak proportion lah. Okay, gambar tak proportion. So if you want to declare resize the file without knowing the proportion, tak mau kira dia punya scale, just add height, either height or width. You nak cari height, you pakai height, or you nak guna lebar saja, guna width saja. So so if you using height, it will automatically calculate the proportional width for this image. If you use width saja, it will calculate the proportional height for this image. Okay, vice versa. Okay, so I'm going to use width. Okay, now so we have two image. Okay, one is scaled up. Oh, gambar saya kat sini sikit. Okay, so image, we have two kind of two image. Okay, so actually this is the same image. Alright, so one is bigger, then this is smaller. This one is scaled down using HTML syntax. And this one is original picture. So if you want to resize the look, you can use this syntax. Okay, width or height, but the size of the image still remain the same. Okay, laptop. Say the image will be 157 kilobyte. Okay, this one is not suitable to make example. So kita tengok yang dot laptop ni. Kita ambil pengnya dulu. Okay, rename, copy, and kita replace saja kat sini. Kita nak pakai image, save. Alright, so I'm going to use that image. Oh, see, missing image here. Dot letter. Oh, save. Double JPEG. Save. Refresh. Okay, we have the largest image here, and we have the smaller image here. Okay, now back to our working folder. So now kita nak resize. Gambar ni 1.2 MB. It's quite large for an image in a website. Alright, so nak scale down, you scale guna syntax width or height. But the sizing of the file is remain the same, 1.2 MB. Okay, it's not a good thing for a website. Okay, untuk gambar sebesar 1-2 MB is okay, but not good enough. Because most of our user using a website using mobile phone, so they are limited to bandwidth and quota of their data. So website, bila you view website, actually you downloading everything, the content, into your mobile phone to be viewed. Okay, so how many data to be viewed by user, okay, depends on your content of the website. So kalau you punya website content terlalu besar, so dia akan affect the speed of that website to be retrieved to end user. Alright, so in visually you akan nampak this image is smaller than this one, but in terms of file size is not smaller, it's the same. Alright, so to do that, okay, you're going to open any any image editor yang ada available, and you boleh go and you kena compress lah. So kalau Photoshop dia ada save for web, then you boleh pilih to quality, maximum quality, but the size will be okay. Sizing, you resize into 800 pixel from wait. Okay, nampak size dia. Okay, original 1.2 MB, optimized 200k. Alright, so this one is downloading time for 56 kilobyte per second internet speed. Eh? Okay, 38 second to be retrieved. This one, tak beritahu. Eh? Okay, ni speed dia. Alright, so kalau you rendahkan lagi, very high, so dia akan rendah lagi lah, lagi laju. Alright, so very high is quite good. Tick progressive supaya image tu dah akan download berkadar-kadar. Eh? Save. Save dalam ni. Save balik dalam image ni. Okay. Okay, saya letak sebagai laptop. Optimize. Save. Okay. So bila kita buat macam tu, okay, we have this one dash optimize. Save. So we have 1, 2, and 3. Okay, original 800 and 300 width. So this one. Right, so kalau buat width kat sini, width 200 pixel, save. Nampak? So similar image, okay, similar image, but different in kind in terms of sizing. Right, in terms of sizing is different. This one is quite large image. This one, quite large image. But not optimized. This one optimized. So basically image ni sebenarnya kalau internet kamu slow, and this one is quite laju sikit to download compared to this one. Alright. Now kita ada external. Okay, kita ada static image, and we go to external image. Okay, similar. So this one is static image yang kita internal image lah. So daripada file kita sendiri. Alright. So to create external image, of course, we declare source dia daripada mana. Kita cari mana-mana website yang ada image. Okay, this one Google Console. Alright, this one. Okay, ambil je gambar. So ini gambar kan, I click copy image link, and copy image link je. Okay, so go back to our HTML, paste. Okay, so here is our link. Okay, from where? From where did this image come from? Okay, save. So should be kita dapat retrieve lah. Nampak? Okay, image ni daripada website ini. So kalau website ini dia tukar nama file, kan? Dia tukar nama file, so kita dapat tukar. Contoh dia tukar nama intent tu, tu. Tapi kat kita still maintain this one, so kita tak dapat lah image tu. Ya, image missing, so kita dapat. Alright. Jadi kalau image missing, okay, kita ada satu lagi kita panggil sebagai alternate text. Alright, alternate text yang mana tambah je ke atas ni. Okay, tambah atas ni. Alternate text equal to, okay, images, image of a puppy using iPad. Okay, the use of this alternate text is to let user know if the image is lost. Okay, so image ni ada kat sini. Sepatutnya ada image kat sini, but there's something wrong with the image and the image doesn't show in the document. So using this alternate text will show and tell people that that this is an image of a puppy using iPad. Alright, and this one also improve our the website as search engine optimization because the text describing an image. Okay. Alright, so we have static, external, and of course kita ada the syntax is similar, okay, but the type of image will differ and give different look to your website. For example, we have animated image kat sini. Okay, ni yang cat.gif ni. So GIF ni, this is animated text and animated image yang support by most browser. Alright, so still in folder images, this is the file name. Save, and we have animated text, animated image, this one. Okay, so with the right execution, this animated GIF can bring some. So it actually is going to tally with your theme, tema website kamu. So the theme will be more fun and interactive. Yes, you can include this kind of animated graphics, but if your target user is more to corporate and more to serious and professional user, so including animated GIF is not recommended. Okay, but it's all depends on your design wise. It's all depends on your design. Now, so we have this one. Okay, now for the background. Okay, so background, previously we have changed the background color. Now how to use image as a background? So kita gunakan CSS lah. Okay, put up style on site head area, head section. Okay, this one we going to use internal CSS. Alright, so kita letak kat sini lah, body section ni. Alright, so select body. Okay, curly bracket. Okay, so cari background image. So inside background image kita guna URL lah. So sama je dengan HTML. Okay, image source, background image, apa URL dia? Okay, so apa URL dia? Dalam kurungan, okay, folder lah. Folder name slash, actually kita kena ada ni. Okay, kita kena ada ni. Okay, so mana? Tiles lah, kita guna tiles. So the use of this kind of image, so this one the repeated pattern ni. So because bila kita double so the size of the screen is bigger than a normal screen, so image tu boleh replicate dan dia boleh bersambung-sambung lah. Okay, macam tiles dia nampak sama aja. So compare tu kita tengok gambar laptop kita pakai. This one bila dia bercantum sebelah, dia tak boleh stitch lah, tak cantik. So kita guna touch ni cantik sikit sebab dia akan berulang-ulang eh, repeated. JPG save. Okay, so we have a background. Okay, we have a background. Okay, so we finish up using images. Okay, we have background, we have image, and so static, external, and animated GIF. Alright, so now we go to image map. Okay, image map ni a bit tricky, but by using correct ways, okay, correct method, step by step, you can achieve some function. So certain requirement of website kita sonok pakai image map ni. For example, we have this kind of maps, Malaysian map ni. Okay, so the use of HTML image map is to use single image, and user can click, and developers can trace down any pattern inside an image to make it clickable, or to make it hyperlink. Okay, to change it to hyperlinks, any patterns. Okay, so basically to use an image map, alright, so there are three basic shape for image map. Okay, so there are three basic shape of image maps. So first we have circle. Okay, first we have circle, alright, and then the second we have rectangle, and another one we have polygon. Okay, so polygon, any shape yang kita letak dot tu, okay, resemble how much bucu yang ada lah. Okay, so we have circle, we have rectangle, and we have polygon. Okay, tiga shape saja lah dalam heat map ni. Okay, to use heat map. Okay, first to use heat map, heat map ke hot map, image map lah. Okay, first we going to pull out the image. First we going to pull out the image. Okay, kita memang dah ada siap-siap lah image ni, malaysianmap.png. See, png. Alright, images/malaysia-map.png. Alright, so ni dia. So bila kita save, and we have a Malaysian map kat sini lah. Okay, we have a Malaysian map kat sini. Now to plot this item, okay, so basically kita akan guna coordinates. Okay, so kita akan guna coordinates. Okay, coordinates contohnya. So before kita nak guna map area tu, kita kena bind this image. So use map equal to mesti include hashtag Malaysia map. Ni nama ni kita boleh ubah apa-apa. Okey, kita boleh ubah apa saja kita nak ubah. Okey, sebab kita nak bagi nama nama special je supaya kita boleh link. Okey. Hot map ke, okey, depends lah. Sebab kita nak guna kat sini. Sebab kita nak guna dekat map name equal to okey, hot map. Macam tu. Okey. So kalau you declare sini Malaysia map, sini pun kena sama. Sebab map ni akan guna image ini. So dia akan link antara dua ni. Binding use map and map name untuk map Malaysia map gambar ni lah. Alright. So untuk firstly kita akan gunakan array shape lah. Nak guna array shape ni maksudnya kita nak declare shape and jenis macam mana. So before this, just now I've mentioned area map have three shape. Okay, rectangle, circle and polygon. Okay, so first kita gunakan rectangle lah, contoh rectangle. Okay, so area shape, okay, equal to, okay, apa jenisnya, rectangle, ini nama dia, rectangle. and kita set coordinates dia. So bila rectangle, untuk untuk dapatkan rectangle dari dua koordinat lah. Okey. Nampak ni, satu koordinat satu. Okey, maksudnya x dan y. X dan y, satu titik persilangan. Ini pula x dan y, satu titik persilangan. So dapatlah. Dia tarik, dapat koordinat dia. Okey. Mana? Okey, koordinat. Contoh kita ambil daripada sisi 34, 34, okay, second bucu 278, 3560. Okay, so dekat situ kita tengok hyperlink reference, ni link ni link dia. Okay, contoh nak pergi google.com ataupun kita kena pakai ni. Kalau external kita kena pakai HTTPS ya. Okey, kita pakai itu. Okey, cantik dah ni. Okey. Tapi kita kena close down map ni. Save. Okey. Okey, kita dapatlah. So map, this map bind to this image and kita dah declare area shape to be rectangle and this first coordinate and this second coordinate and this shape will direct to google.com. Okay, save. Okay, where is it? Okay, pasal tak cursor saya bertukar warna petunjuk ni. Okay, bertukar penunjuk. This is area hot map ni lah. Ini tak boleh klik. This one boleh klik, go to Google. Okay, ni bukti lah. Okay, so soalan macam mana kita nak betul-betul senang nak draw lukisan ni, macam nak buat? Ada cara dia. Cara yang paling mudah, kita guna third party tools lah. Okay, third party tools yang mana kamu pergi ke image dashmap.net lah. Okay, this one. So ni paling senang kita nak guna lah. Okay, select image from PC. Okay, mana this one lah. Okay, senang lah. So dari tiga jenis macam kita cakap tadi, okay, contoh we going to use poly. Alright, so poly in this map, klik satu. Okay, because polygon dia akan depends pada how many dot yang kita akan nak guna. Okay, okay, kita dapat lah satu. Okay, link je terus pergi https double dot facebook.com. Huh, macam tu. Alright, so you want to insert another one, add new area. For example, you want to create rectangle. Okay, this is rectangle. Okay, first coordinate and second coordinate. Dapatlah. Ini maksudnya tarik daripada first coordinate ke second coordinate. Dapatlah. Okay, https double dot slash tm dot edu.my. Okay, so second, add new item, kita nak gunakan circle. So macam yang kita mention, saya mention tadi just now. So for circle we have one dot and second dot is for the radius. Ha, begitu. Okay, kita ambil kat mana ni? Sini, Johor. Okay, so link https double dot slash slash utm.edu.my. Okay, try lah. Okay, so macam mana dapat code dia? Show me the code. Okay, ambil ini je, nanti kita modify. Okay, ambil ini je, nanti kita modify. Save. Okay, ni kita dah pakai, ni yang kita guna kan. Ha, kita guna ini, kita ambil ini. Ha, nampak? So the first one, area target ni tak perlulah kan. Okay, biar je kat sini. Sebab target ni kita nak tengok nanti. Di alternate target ni kita akan belajar dekat links, hyperlinks yang akan relate dengan hyperlink reference ni lah. Okay, ni dia hyperlink reference ni, link mana yang nak pakai, nak ke mana. Okay, this is coordinate dia. Coordinate dia nampak? Titik pertemuan, titik tengah dia XY, berapa radius. Okay, so mana this one, rectangle, shape, rectangle. Okay, first coordinate, second coordinate. Tapi untuk polygon, nampak? Untuk polygon, nampak koordinat dia. Satu koordinat, dua koordinat, tiga dan seterusnya. Okay. So if you see, so belum sebelah lagi. So sini kita guna Malaysia map, kan? Yang ni datang daripada image map tu, kita kena replace lah. Dia dah tak jadi. Mesti sama dengan apa yang kamu umpan kat sini. Save. Refresh. Supposedly kamu boleh klik lah. Tengok Terengganu, tengok area Terengganu. Mouse saya akan hover, klik. Pergi ke Facebook. Okay. Pergi ke area atas ni, ni square. Klik, akan pergi ke mana? UATM. Okay. And this one, circle tadi kat mana? Ke Johor kan? This an area circle. Okay, klik, akan pergi ke UTM. Macam tu. Okay, tips dia. So, bila kamu dah dapat macam ni, you tak boleh pakai. Okay, kita tak boleh pakai lah UI semua tu. Okay, 4400 pixel contoh. Dah tak boleh pakai lah width. Sebab apa? Contoh kita pakai width kan. Tak, kotak dia kat sini. Terengganu tak capai. Dia sampai kat sini. Ni Terengganu yang asal. Sebab apa? Sebab kita dah pakai kat sini. Okay, ni gambar original dia. So kalau you nak berguna sizing, okay, untuk image map, enter sizing ni, jangan ubah dekat HTML. So dekat HTML jangan pakai width, supaya dia maintain image yang kita pakai originally dekat website ni. Sebab dia kat sini, dia proses koordinat XY kat sini. So kita kecilkan XY tu, dah ada tempat lain lah. Okay, boleh faham eh? Okay, itu sahaja untuk kali ni. So kita dah, we have learned about images, okay, background using internal CSS, static, external, animated GIF, and we have heat map. Image map for HTML. Okay, so that's all. Kita akan jumpa next video untuk hyperlinks. Okay, insyaAllah hyperlinks kita guna. Okay, sekian. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum.